Welcome to CNC Parts and Services and Machinery Empire presentation. Today we have for you, it's a Huaxian high-tech 700 lathe with 24-inch chuck, hydraulic chuck, and 4.6-inch spindle through hole, which goes all the way out. And it has a 12-station turret and tailstock, also tool setter installed on the machine. And this is a very nice machine. It's when it was made in 2007, and I'm just going to show you a basic operation so we can see how it works. It is equipped with 18 ITB controller by Fanuc, very nice control. Also, it's 2007, so it has the newer style drive on it, as you can see. Very nice two-gear headstock. It's got two gears, it's a gear headstock. This is newer electronics on it. This is a 2007 and a B version of the Fanuc 18i controller. Also, the serial number of the machine. The machine is Huaxian machine tool. Model number high-tech 700. And the serial number is M073355G3I and last letter A. Made in 2007. That 07. It has a spindle cooler also, so spindle chiller, big loop pump, and hydraulic pump also. So it's got full options and a very nice option. It is actually the spindle chiller, which is pretty good, keeps the machine nice and cold. And this goes for a spindle chiller. It distributes all the coolant plus oil all over the battery, so you should have no problems with the headstock or with the spindle bearings. They are actually lubricated by oil, so it should be long lasting. This is actually a very nice design. So of course the 12 station turret, you know, you can put up to 12 tools, and it's a very big one also. It's not one of the small ones, so in case you crash it or something happens which goes wrong with sometimes with machining a part, you'll be okay, you'll be fine on it. It can take a hit, so you won't have any trouble. And now I'm gonna just demonstrate how smooth the axes run. And first of all, I'll move Z. First of all, we zero it out. So let me go over reference. I'll zero out the X first. And goes on X, and now we'll zero out the Z. And I'm actually dropped it 50. There it goes. It's very nice and quiet machine. I really like it a lot. It goes to zero right now. We are at zero. Now we'll I'll just jog it back and forth. First of all, in Z axis. So let me come out. Jog. Yeah, we're at speed rate. We go rapid now, and this is actually in rapid. As you can hear, very very smooth and nice motion. It moves very smoothly. Axes are in very very good shape. Also the X axis, we go rapid. As you can see, very very nice and smooth motion. It's a very very good machine in very good shape. I'm gonna rotate the turret right now. Let me find the turret button. Let me rotate the turret. The turret also, it's not hydraulic. It's actually, it's not hydraulic. It's servo driven, so that's why it sounds very quiet, and also during the maintenance it's a little bit better because you don't have those front locking or hunting gears on it. You know, it's just have the clamp, unclamp, and the servo is driving the turret by itself. Also, like I said about the headstock's got two gears on it, and I'm just gonna switch from low gear to high gear in jog mode. And this is a high gear completed change. We're gonna go to a low gear. It is a low gear right now. We're in low gear, and now I'm just gonna give it an MDI command. I don't have it warm up, so we're gonna do pretty slowly. Start with S100, M03, move it forward, inset, and I cycle start it. That's 100 RPMs in a first gear on 24 inch chuck with 4.6 inch through hole. Very nice. And you have some serious horsepower on that machine. It's got a nice geared head and a big spindle motor of 75 kW. So the drive itself, it's 75. So this is one of the biggest ones they make. So you could put a very big tools, and you can take lots of stock with it. Also very helpful, it's a tail stock. You have to actually, it's draggable, so you have to actually drag it. It doesn't have a ball screw to be propelled, but you drag it behind the z-axis. So for example, you go back with it, you clamp it, this thing comes out, you unclamp the tail stock, and the axis will actually drag the tail stock wherever you want. And then you set up the tail stock, the quill itself, you know, which will come out and come back. And that's the first gear. Let me switch it to a second gear. Stop it, M05 first. Yeah. Stopping, it's got the braking, active braking. And let me go M42. That's M42 gear change. We're in a second gear. And let me try maybe 500 RPMs. And I hope it's not going to limit us. Yeah, and we are at 500 RPMs on the second gear. Very nice and quiet for such a big chuck. It's a 24 inch chuck, and I think it weighs around 300 kilograms itself. So it's got some serious torque on it. Let me stop it. Go M05. That's active braking. It stopped in second gear. Let me switch it to a low gear. Go back to jog mode, low gear. We're back in the low gear. All right, so I showed you how nice the machine works, the axis, the turret itself, and also what else we could do. I don't have air hook up to it, so I'm not gonna show you a tool setter, but tool setter, it's works. Let me maybe zero it out again, we send it home, and we try to advance the tool setter on it. Okay, we're going back to zero, there it goes, we're going back home, right, back, almost there, back home, okay, there it goes, and I'm gonna try to in jog mode, two-setter, go advanced two-setter. Yeah, it clicked, so the valve clicked, but I don't have the air on, so maybe, yeah, there it goes. Yeah, the two-setter itself, it's right here, so the tool setup and tool measurement, it's very nice and very easy for that. All side works, so, and also before we ship it, and if you like the machine, before we ship it, also we'll use our Renshaw ball bar tester to calibrate the machine for you, so it's gonna be a dead on, you don't have to worry about how we're retracting. Oh, there it goes, retracts, right, let's do it. Alright, there we go. So we will calibrate it on a Renshaw ball bar tester, so it should be all set for production. And right now the machine is located in Houston, Texas. The zip code is 77040. We don't have the 40,000 pound forklift right now. We have only our smaller one, 20,000 pound forklift, so we won't be able to load it anytime. Any kind of a loading will have to be, we'll have to order riggers, so you will have to give us at least a couple days in advance for loading. Thank you so much for watching. Please send us any questions. I'm gonna try to list as many specs I have on the eBay site, so you actually know everything about the machine. It's pretty new, it's 2008, very nice controller, a whole bunch of offsets for work, for offset for the tools itself. And it's 18 ITB control, one of the latest ones. Right now you have the 31, 32 I's, but 18 IB version, it's actually the I would say one before the newest controller. So it's got all of the options needed, you know, for a simple, nice lathe like this. Thank you so much for watching, and hopefully we do some business together. Thank you, bye-bye.